I guess I wanted to add this to the front of the video because in the last one I got a bunch of questions asking how I had already had this store of a bunch of people saying that they were also in the alpha skip ahead or they were in like maybe the alpha preview, and it's just random who gets it at first. You can read down here, it's just like it's only available to a random subset of users even within the alpha skip ahead. They do that for certain updates to the console. They'll just select random people, even within the alpha skip ahead ring, to get an early look at a new update. I mean, it makes sense to do that. I mean, you don't want to just, even though they test it behind doors to make sure like consoles aren't exploding or something like that, when they're pushing it to us, like the people even in the alpha skip ahead ring, that's a lot more people than they've got and their labs running these things, so they don't want to just like dump it out there and there be catastrophic issues. They've done that before. It really, 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 really sucks. So it makes sense for them to do that. So I'm not like handpicked. I'm not anyone special. I'm sure they don't know I exist. I just got picked out of a random number generator, probably. So that's pretty much as far as that goes. I don't have a way of inviting people into the insider program. At least, like, when it first started, that's the way it used to be, but there's no way for me to, like, bring you in. I'm not sure how to join, even at this point. So, unfortunately, if you want to get into the new store experience, there's really not a way that you can fast-track your way into it, because even to get inside of the alpha skip ahead ring, you have to have been inside of the insider program for quite a while. For some reason I'm thinking it was like at least 6 months, but it could have been like way more time than that to get to this ring when they first introduced it. So anyway, I'm taking up enough time. I'll just get on with the rest of the video. Hey guys, Overlord Actual, back taking a look at an update for the Microsoft Store for Xbox, the new store. So right off the bat, I want to head right down here to settings and let you know that they did finally add the autoplay video thing. So now I've already got it turned off. They've added an option for disable motion, which is like the background behind like all of the game tiles, that thing, that animation. So you can disable that. They've pushed out the settings, like all the text used to be smashed up against like the edge right here that splits between the sidebar and actual like settings options there. They changed the icon for the redeem, which is, you know, whatever. I didn't think it really mattered too much considering you have to type it in on the Xbox anyway. It's weird that they have the QR code when you can't, like, you can't actually do that. Connect still works, but like they don't sell the adapter or anything, and the amount of people who would actually be able to use a QR code on their Xbox is pretty slim at this point. Let's see, is this cart new? I'm pretty sure it is. I'm pretty sure that wasn't there before, and I kind of want to see about okay, so yeah, just add the cart, keep shopping. Let's add something else from the wish list. Metro Exodus, sure. Regular one. Nice to see they still have those. Let's view cart. See what the cart looks like. So, oh, it's got the order summary plus applicable tax. So. Alright, so it's just a subtotal, not the final. I wonder what the checkout page looks like now. Okay, so that's pretty cool. Got a help number and everything up there. Payment options, which you're not going to be able to see, but so. Seems fun. Someone was asking if you could add like original Xbox and 360 games to your wish list. You can. I don't know why you wouldn't have been able to. People are also asking if the stores for original Xbox and the 360 games, like their store pages, look any different. They don't. I don't know why they would look any different from like Xbox One games. If they're redesigning the entire store, I mean, you would think that you would want to keep, like, you want to have everything look the same or fall in line, keep a consistent theme to it. So they do all look the same. So yeah, that was, yeah, just a question someone asked. A lot of people were telling me before, in a previous video, they were just like, well, if you want to get rid of the autoplay videos, all you got to do is press the menu button. Well, guess what? Now it is there. I was pressing the menu button before. All I had was add to wish list, so it's available now. Like I was telling some people, Larry Hryb must have been on the different build of the store than me. So, but it's really weird. If they already had that one available, they would have thought they just pushed that right at the beginning. I don't know why I was on some kind of different one. So, moving to the right, it still disappears everything off to the left, which I don't particularly care for. Games now has like a new thing, like game specials. In my opinion, they kind of regressed here because before on, let me go back on home. Like these sections up here, they led to like a store page that just had like all of the like a publisher's things all together. So now, if you go back to game specials, it's just a mosh pit of just a whole bunch of different things. They're not even like they're not grouped together or anything at this point. Not really. You got like Metro Exodus here, and Metro right here, and then you got another Metro thing here. Before, they had them all grouped together like a publisher thing. So there'd be the Bethesda stuff all together. Then there'd be like the like 2K stuff. So like it made sense the other way to me, or at least I can't find a way to get back to that like store page. So that's a little bit weird to me. Maybe it's under. Yeah. I guess it's gone. Maybe I'll keep looking around. If I end up finding it, I'll try to like edit into the video or something. But I'm not. Oh, I was kind of sad to see that go, honestly. So, other than that. Oh, there's one other thing. So if we go to, actually no, we're already in the right place. I just gotta go back to like game specials. So the filter option, you can see the filter bar in the top right-hand corner. In the previous video, in the previous build for me, there was like a sort bar, and so you were supposed to be able to get to that by hitting the right bumper. That's gone now. It didn't work anyway, and it was also pretty redundant, so that's good. This dropdown still only has three things here. It can be a heck of a lot longer. Like, it can be a much longer dropdown instead of having to go through all of these. Like, only showing three things, like I said before, is a little bit ridiculous. Hopefully they'll get around to changing that, I think. I certainly hope that they change it back to where like all of this Dragon Ball Z stuff would all be grouped in the like one store page. Also, I said in the previous video, I would want, like, you see how there's only like one real row of available games? I still want it to where if they could just like reduce the size of these icons here, or maybe like this huge preview thing up at the top, like scrunch, like just make that a little bit smaller and just get two full rows of available that are viewable at a time here. That'd be really nice. If they don't, it's really not that big of a deal. Like I said in the last video, you can pretty much see what's coming up. It's just it I think it'd look a lot cleaner that way. Other than that, I think the store looks fine. Still, I mean, weren't really like there weren't huge changes, but there were some nice changes, noticeable changes that I saw that I thought were pretty. I was happy about. I was really surprised that they got another update out so quickly for me. It's only been what, 5 days, so that's pretty cool. And yeah, I think that's pretty much all I got for this one. I mean, take a look at wish list. There's nothing that's changed here. This all looks the same. So yeah, so thanks for watching, and maybe if there's another update soon of significance, I'll make another video. So thanks for watching.